The 47th New Japan Pro Wrestling Anniversary Show is right around the corner, and it's time for my preview here. The 7th match card. No 8 match card, a 7 match card, but it's a hell of a card. It is one of the best, if not the best, anniversary show cards I've seen in a long time. This show is fucking stacked. Just like for an anniversary show, this is insane. For just a regular card, this is still a great card. Like, if it was just a, you know, a Wrestling Duntaku card, like, this be like, this is fucking awesome. Like, this is, there's some good matches on here that I want to see. And that's, and I hope it becomes a highly sought after show after it's all said and done. As we start off the opener, a little 10-man tag. As we got Ren Narita, Shoto Yumino, Yoto Yoshida, Toriano, and Togi Makabe on team number one, taking on, basically the Bullet Club team. They got Hikuleu, Chase Owens, Tongalo, and Tama Tonga, and Bad Luck Fale. Hikuleu coming. This is the first match on that'll be part of the that is gonna be previewed and reviewed on the channel. As of course he made his kind of big comeback during the Honor Rising show in a run-in after a match. As we have a lot, obviously one of the young lions is gonna take the fall. Don't know which one, as also to Tonga Lo and Tama Tonga, obviously they've been booked for the big title-for-title tag match happening at the G1 Supercard show. So I don't think they're going to lose to like a Toriano Togi Makabe team to kind of help maybe have to build up to a tag team title match in the future. But obviously also with the New Japan Cup too. There's really no point, so we'll have, you know, either a Chase Owens, or even one of the G.O.D. members, or Bad Luck Fale, like, Pin, one of the Young Lions, there as the next match, little tag team matchup, Toa Inari and Yuji Nagata taking on Yoshihashi and Tomori Ishii, as, Inari's gonna take the fall, but this is gonna be used to build the Yuji Nagata, Tomori Ishii, New Japan Cup match that's happening. They have a first-round matchup, but I'm very excited for it. Obviously, they've been building for a while. It was supposed to be on the new beginning in the USA shows, but because of visa issues, that was not to be done. So I'm actually glad they've waited this long to do it instead of doing it at the new beginning in US show. As, you know, I got to actually see it instead of having to fly to a city to watch it. As, you know, I'll say Yoshihashi pins Toa Inari to kind of keep Yuji Nagata and Tomori Ishii strong but away from each other to build up to their New Japan Cup match. But I'm excited to see those interactions, of course, between Yuji Nagata and Tomori Ishii. That match I'm very looking forward to seeing. The next 10-man tag, third match on the card, we have Dragon Lee, Raisuke Taguchi, Tiger Mask 4, Tomoaki Hanman, Satoshi Kojima of Team Number 1, taking on Taka Michinoku, El Desperado, Yoshinobu Kanemaru, Taichi, Minoru Suzuki. He's obviously a Suzuki gun versus babyface team, as, you know, Dragon Lee's back with New Japan for this tour. I'm assuming they'll build him up against El Desperado, kind of building up between those two. They had a little mini rivalry going throughout the Best of Super Juniors last year, as, you know, Desperado would take his mask, and Dragon Lee would try to take his mask, and type of thing, and we could see that happening here on this card. There's been rumblings going on in the world that Hiromu Takahashi is going to make his big comeback for the G1 Supercard show at the Garden, and they're going to try to do Dragon Lee and Hiromu Takahashi. That's going to be fucking crazy if that would happen. I'd be a little terrified, obviously, if it happened, but, I mean, if there's a rivalry that deserves to have a match at Madison Square Garden in the modern time, it's probably that. I mean, it's either that, or it was fucking Okada and Omega. Or even, you know, Tanahashi, Okada. There's a bunch now that I'm thinking about it. Kind of one of the many, I'll say. One of the very many feuds in wrestling in the modern era would have never had a chance to have a match in Madison Square Garden. The Dragon Lee and Roman Takahashi feuds and matches definitely were a fucking barn burner and a half. And if that was to happen again here at the G1, obviously the last time those two wrestled in a New Japan ring, Roman Takahashi had a broken neck, but I don't think it's going to happen twice. Listen, it was a one-time accident. I think it's going to be okay, But that's something we could see build towards. I don't think it's going to happen on this show. I don't think Roman's going to come back and they'll have a thing. But if that happens, that'd be fucking insane. And, but yeah, I think it's going to plant the seeds. You know, we'll have a Dragon Lee, El Desperado kind of match, maybe in the finals of the New Japan Cup, and then Hirama's going to show up type of thing. Could definitely see that happening. As, you know, that's just kind of been the rumblings. I still don't think Hirama's ready yet. It's been, you know, not even... it's not even been a full year, so I don't think he's ready to come back yet and even an angle even have, like, a promo capacity. Still, you know, kind of let him keep rehabbing, not trying to... Because even then, if he comes back for the G1 Supercard show, that's still hella early to be coming back from an injury that he had. So you think just we'll keep that as a rumor, and we'll just say that for, hey, maybe, you know, 2 years down the line, or maybe 3 years down the line, if they still are running a show at Madison Square Garden, those two have to match there, it'd be fucking dope. And you know, as far as who's going to win this goddamn thing, I'll go with Suzuki Gun getting the win. I think Suzuki's going to make somebody tap. Or even Tai Chi getting a little quick victory to kind of keep his momentum going after losing to Naito and whatnot. Hanma, Tai Chi, and Taguchi are all in the New Japan Cup, and Tai Chi and Minoru Suzuki. And Satoshi Kojima's taking on Minoru Suzuki in the first round. Hanma's taking on Tai Chi in the first round. So a little build up to the New Japan Cup here in this for this 10-man tag. Could definitely see the interactions. Obviously, Kojima and Suzuki, I'm probably more looking forward to the most between those two matches. I think I enjoy Tai Chi and I enjoy Hanma's work, but just them together doesn't really do anything for me in a match against each other. But Kojima and Suzuki, that would be, you know, be awesome to see. Obviously, it'd been awesome like 10 years ago, but listen, that's neither here nor there. Let's not hold that against them from getting older. As, I'm still going to stick with Suzuki Gun getting the win over the babyface team. Even though I'm kind of going, you know, I did the same thing with the heels winning the first match. So we'll have the babyfaces win this third match here. I think maybe, you know, a Taguchi win here to kind of springboard him. He's going to pin Taka Michinoku. I'm all over the place with this. But that's going to be my final answer. Taguchi over Taka Michinoku. There, as next match, junior heavyweight tag team title match, Sho and Yo, the challengers taking on Shingo and Bushi. That's nice that these two teams can have a regular two-on-two tag match here, not have a Suzuki Gun third wheel. Very nice to see how this plays out. I think Shingo and Bushi are still going to win. They're going to keep Shingo strong a little bit longer and have these guys have a bit of a reign, as this would be their second defense now. After, with this match here, I'm very looking forward to seeing this, though. This is gonna be a banger if they let these guys go, and I think they will. You know, this is just a seventh match card. They have the extra time they're not used to having this, a free match, compared to an eight-match card. I think they'll give a lot of these guys some time, and it's gonna be a banger. I really do think so. These guys, they have pretty good chemistry from what we've seen so far. Yeah, hopefully it gets brought out even more with just these two teams going at it. But, you know, Shingo and Bushi, I think they're going to retain. But it wouldn't surprise me, though, if they lost. You know, this is kind of a show to do it. There's not the only other title match on this card is the next match, the Junior Heavyweight title match. And I don't think Ishimori is losing, so there's that. We could have a little title change on this show to kind of add a little bit more oomph to the card. That, not that it needs it or anything, but it's just something that could possibly happen. As the next match, IWGP Junior Heavyweight Championship matchup, Jushin Thunder Liger taking on Taiji Ishimori, the 55-year-old Jushin Thunder Liger getting a title shot. Sure, he's not going to win. But goddammit, if they give me hope. If they just they've already given me hope by him beating him in that tag match on Rising, which was such an awesome finish. It's a flash out of nowhere pin. Was awesome. It'd be so awesome if Liger won here, but come on. As much as I love that, wouldn't really make sense in the grand scheme of things. Sure, it'd be awesome, but Ishimori, he could use the win. Have another title. Have a longer title reign after this. Plus, I'm assuming he's going to hold the belt until after the Best of Super Juniors, would be my guess. as far as, you know, for just kind of a lengthy reign for him to have. This is going to be a fun match, though. I can't wait to see it. Anytime Liger's in a big marquee match, it's fucking awesome. Maybe not quality-wise, if you're just kind of like a fan who's not blinded by the nostalgia glasses he's wearing and doesn't just love Jushin Thunder Liger to death. It might be just an eh match as far as junior heavyweight title matches from comparing them to recent junior heavyweight title matches. But it's going to be awesome. I think the crowd's going to be into it. I hope the crowd's into it. If not, I'll have to slap them. But it should be a fun match. It should be fun. Should be fun to watch. And it's going to be, hopefully it's reminiscent of this match against Hiromu Takahashi from the Best of Super Juniors, his last Best of Super Juniors in Cork and all, where it's just a highly emotional thing. I don't think it's going to be to that level, because it's not like, I mean, this very well could be his last junior heavyweight title matchup they'll ever have, but also it's not like set in stone that's going to be it type of thing. If it was set in stone that this was going to be it, I think that emotional level to it would be there, but it just hasn't been promoted as that yet. But the crowd's going to be into it. If not, shame on them. Shame on them. And I'm very looking forward to seeing. Basically, these last four matches, I'm looking forward to seeing. As the co-main event, a special little six-man tag, Hirooki Goto, Kazuchika Okada, Roshi Tanahashi taking on Sanada, Evil, and Tetsuya Naito, LIJ, Chaos with Hiroshi Tanahashi matchup here. I mean, we got three of the top four New Japan stars in a match. That's pretty fucking awesome. You don't get that every day. As especially like a co-main event, too. Like, that's pretty crazy. As obviously Okada and Naito, they haven't really touched in like forever since their Wrestle Kingdom match. So that's awesome. And Tanahashi Naito, they've rarely touched, too. They've also not touched in a long-ass time. So that, again, is another thing. Just basically, I'm sure they'll limit the Naito Okada and limit the Naito Tanahashi stuff, but man, I'm sure before that bell rings and you have Naito face off with either Okada or Tanahashi, that place is going to go fucking crazy. And as it should, I mean, this could really lead into a Naito Tanahashi number one contendership matchup. For either, and not even, like, them as, like, a heavyweight contention. But even, like, a shocking, like, holy shit, Goto can beat Naito to have, like, an Intercontinental title shot at a later show. Also, too, I forget just how the brackets are looking as far as the New Japan Cup goes off the top of my head. But, they are bringing champions into the fold besides the heavyweight champion Jay White, so part of me kind of thinks that's kind of shitty. I kind of love the non-title, the non-champions in the New Japan Cup, but it's going to bring the more exciting matches, so you can't really fault that. And, you know, some more positives, more negatives, instead of, like, the negatives being, I loved when the belts, when the champions weren't in it because it gave more guys opportunity that wouldn't have an opportunity, and kind of give the champions a break and make them stand out even more and be more important. But that's just my two cents. But yeah, you know, as far as who can this benefit for this six-man tag, obviously Sanada and Evil losing their belts against G.O.D. at the Honor Rising show. Hopefully they don't take the fall here, but someone's got to fucking lose in this six-man tag. And it would, I mean, they are kind of lesser stars, them and Hirooki Goto on the other side. I don't think Okada or Tanahashi is going to take the fall. That would be some shit. But if someone's going to pin him, it might be Naito, you know, as far as someone to lose in one of these multi-man matches. It'd be a one against Tetsuya Naito. But very looking forward to seeing this six-man tag plays out. One of the most highly anticipated six-man tag matches for me throughout the New Japan year in 2019 will be this six-man tag, that's for sure. Really, I'm not really feeling who's going to be a winner or a loser here, too. It's kind of, at one point, it's kind of like it's a special match for this anniversary show, so there's really nothing going to be built into the future with a six-man tag, but it's fun. It's a fun little six-man tag, especially for this co-main event. As far as the main event goes, we have a champion versus champion main event. Will Ospreay, the Never Openweight Champion, versus Jay White, the IWGP Heavyweight Champion. Obviously, this is, for the anniversary show, the main event's always a special little attraction main event that will only happen at a anniversary show. 2 or 3 years ago, they had Okada, who was the IWGP Heavyweight Champion, taking on Tagamaster W, of course, Kota Ibushi. That was fun. Last year was a Junior Heavyweight Champion versus Heavyweight Champion, Will Ospreay versus Kazuchika Okada. And here we have, they switched it up with now a Never Openweight Champion versus the IWGP Heavyweight Champion. As far as, obviously, this is also another rematch from Ring of Honor. This was Jay White's best match from his excursion at Ring of Honor War of the Worlds. These two had a match, and it was fucking awesome. It was a killer match. Just a fucking banger. Probably the best Ring of Honor match of that year. Just incredible stuff. And here, obviously, it's going to be a very different Jay White than it was on that excursion. But I still think it could be on that level as far as awesome match. Will Ospreay, in a very different now. Both these guys are much different than what they were at that honor at the War of the Worlds show back in Ring of Honor a couple of years back. This is going to be special. I really do think it's going to be special. Maybe not a whole lot of crazy shit's going to happen, but I think these guys are going to bring it. Obviously, Will Ospreay, he's going to bring it every fucking night. Jay White, though, you know, we're going to see. Hopefully, he doesn't have to rely on a lot of heel tactics. We can see glimpses of that crazy style and crazy match they had at Ring of Honor. And kind of leave the heelish dick to the more mainstream shows and kind of give that character a break. But, in a sense, it wouldn't make sense for him to do that. It wouldn't make sense for him not to stray away from that character now that it's finally been put over to the point and brought over to a point, and now that he's at his A-game doing that character, wouldn't really make sense. But just me personally, I think it'd be a cool thing to see. But I doubt it. He'll stick to his character. And as far as who's going to win, obviously I think Jay White's going to win, but that would be fucking crazy if Ospreay would win. That'd be a huge shocker. And it could be credible, too. It's not like it'd be a fluke victory. It would be meaningful. It would be a holy shit. Not only would it give credibility to these matches, to these anniversary day special matches with the champion versus champion aspect to it, as like, holy shit, the IWGP Heavyweight Champion's not safe during these anniversary shows. That'd be awesome to see, but I think New Japan, they'll play it safe. He just beat Tanahashi in a shocking win in the New Beginning shows. Obviously, he wasn't at the Honor Rising show, so here, the next big match after becoming the IWGP Heavyweight Champion, he lost. That would stink. That would stink, but I think he'll bounce back and retain his championship at the G1 Supercard show in the U.S. If that would be the case, if that was the way they would do it, but again, don't think Will Ospreay is going to win. Be cool, but I just don't see it happening. I think Jay White's going to get the win. But that will do it for the review. Hell of a fucking anniversary show that we have here for New Japan. Compared to what's kind of used to being and kind of what there's been in the past, this is a hell of a card. For it, especially being just an anniversary show, hell of a fucking card. And very looking forward to these last four matches, man. This is going to be a lot of fun. And I hope you guys are excited as I am, as I will catch you guys for the review of this anniversary show. Take care.